I don't know, camera 2 is not working, so... Whatever. Thought that was gonna be cooler. Ugh. It's not gonna be much fun now without two cameras. I can't bring one around with me. Thank you. think I know what the matches are? Of course not. That makes sense. 4.
Thank you.
Hey, John. I don't know where my remote is for my dust collector, which is why I have to go walk over and turn it on and off. Which is pretty common for me. I lose everything. It's somewhere around here. Actually, I think it might be in the house. It's in here. I don't
Thank you.
my water bottle. Water. It's pretty high here today. Alright, we got a couple questions. Let's do some questions. Whatever. Alright, so Got Wood Workshop asked me about the hearing protection. These guys right here, they're 3M Tech. I think you can get these, I'm sure you can get them on Amazon. And I think I've seen them at Rocker before too. They're stupid expensive for what they are, like $6. But I was lucky enough to get these on Black Friday for $30 a pair. My dad and I both got a pair that day. So if you can find them on sale, that's definitely a lot better. But they do work really well. They're extremely comfortable. I can wear them for a long period of time. And they got the little radio in them. And you also have a jack for hooking up to like your phone or your... Does anyone have an MP3 player anymore, or is that kind of gone now? Anyone have an actual iPod? But you got a jack for that. And the batteries last pretty long. If you use them hooked up to an external source, they last a lot longer because it's in passive mode. But if you listen to like the radio, then it actually eats up the battery. So I think that I probably get at least 20 or 30 or 40 hours out of a set of batteries if I listen to the radio the whole time. Alright, Christopher Vaccaro asks if I could give a play-by-play. Yes, I'm sorry. I kind of got into the flow of things here, and I just kind of didn't think to talk a little bit about... Maybe I should probably check and see if people can actually hear me. I think so. No one says they can't hear me. Alright, I have a shop radio, I got a stereo in here as well, which I'll have playing sometimes as well if I want to listen to music on there, if I'm doing something at the bench. I'll either have the stereo on, or I'll have a podcast on my phone playing or something like that. Alright, so back to the play-by-play. So far, what I was trying to do was get the rockers kind of situated for the final glue-up. I got this one was already cut out. And that one I cut the profile on, and I flush trim the inside. I'm going to wait to flush trim the outside till after I glue it up, so I can flush them to the legs all in one pass. And the next thing I'm going to do is create the grooves inside. Sorry, I got like the camera's there, but the monitor's over here. It's hard to see where I'm looking. So I'm going to be creating the grooves that go all the way around the inside top section here, which is going to hold a panel. So I went ahead and I marked those with chalk. You can kind of see it back there. I marked it with chalk. which surfaces need the groove run in them. And I'm going to do that with the router, the straight bit, and an edge guide in two passes, one from each edge, to get a centered groove. And then I was going to go look for a panel, which is why I wanted to have the second camera, because we're going to go on a little adventure to find the piece of wood for that, because I haven't selected it yet. So I don't know how far this cord's going to reach, but you might be able to see me over there in the lumber area looking around for a piece of wood for that. So I'm going to go ahead and get set up the groove running with my half-inch spiral straight bit in the router, ready to go. Find my edge guide, then I'll get set up to run those grooves. Yeah. My water. Thank you for your questions, everyone. Back to it. I didn't drink all the beers yet. They're in the fridge. My water bottles didn't fit. But the beers that were in here are in the fridge now. Much better spot for them than out here in the hot shop. Doing right now is just relabeling these, the chalk that I had on here before, so I know which pieces go with which as I take them apart. Let's see, I might have a different angle for this. Two, but it's not, so let's pretend this is camera two. Okay. So I want my panel that goes into here to be 3/4 or so. I'm cutting the groove first before I mill the panel. So I'll mill the panel to fit in this groove. So I'm going to make some guidelines here. Again, it doesn't really matter what the actual final width is. I just want it to be around 3/4. So I'm coming in from both edges on this first one just so I can set up my router. 3/8 inch from each edge, and since this stock is 1.5 inches, that should give me 3/4 inch left in the middle. Boom. Funny how math. Alright. So one thing I'm doing when I'm setting this up to reduce risk a little bit is I'm setting the router bit to cut on the cut to the line furthest from my router's edge guide. That way, because the router can't go any further this way because the edge guide's keeping it there, but there's nothing from keeping it from going this way. So if I set up the against the other edge, if the edge guide comes away from the workpiece, then it's going to come out and you're going to cut into your keep side of the line. This way, if I deviate from that line at all, it's only going to go back into the waste. Oh, deviate up to what, a quarter inch. Quarter inch deep groove should be good enough for this. So that's it. Ready to go. Should I see this out? this is a bit, I think. I think it's an upcut bit. Yes. Judging by the cut, it's an upcut bit. This is gonna be on the legs, same thing. This these are stopped, so I'm gonna stop when I get to the mortar. Bit of split out piece here, so I'm going to glue that back on. It's not that big of a deal, it's inside the mortise, so I can every little piece of the mortise wall helps. I think it's not frozen anymore. I think. Is it moving? Should be fixed. I don't know what happened. It says that it's going again, so I think it's going. working for me. I can watch myself live on the watch page. So theoretically, should be. Here we go! Thank you. I'll get some more water. See what's happening in the comments. Who wants a chip? Play a chip, Tiger. Come over. Alright, so now I have to find something to use for the panels. What are these? I need about 11 inches. Or 10 and a half. I can glue on some strips to the edges to make them wider. To get to 11 inches. I think I have some stock that's like 11 inches long, or that's 11 inches wide in my rack. I might have some 12 inch wide boards over there. I guess that's all I did. Of course, I can go over to my stack of new lumber and just grab, I guess, some 12s and use those. But try and get rid of some of the smaller stuff first. Hopefully I still have it. So let me see if I get this camera positioned so we can look at the lumber. Hey! This might actually work. All right. It's gonna work. So on the ground, some little scraps. I gotta put away still. I think I might have some back here, but who knows. I used it. aside for now.
I thought I had some Y stuff. Quarter. It's most of them what I was thinking about. It's only one of them. So that would be another piece like that. I don't have to have anything. It's 22 inches long. Thank you.
here's the option. Either I glue up those two panels together, or I go pull some more wood. So either I can make some kind of panel out of these two, or see around the corner. Or use these boards right here. That should be wide enough. Let me know! It's up to you, whatever you want me to do. I'm gonna eat a snack. Those two boards, they are the same board, they're just cut into shorts at some point. I probably pulled them for a project and never used them. So either I can make this big panel, which would be, I don't know how difficult that would be, or how good it would look. I don't know, I can try it. But this one has some crash figure down here, and that end down there is curly. Otherwise, I got those big single panels and they have, I think they have some crotch figure on somewhere too. So, anyway, I'll think about it. Thank you. No other options inside. So. Come back to that. I'm thinking waterboard. So yeah, probably let's go with the waterboard. So now I'm gonna let's skip ahead a little bit and two rails. So four rails that connect the two side assemblies together. That's good. These are the lower rails, and they're still oversized, so I have to plane them down to 1.5 inches square, which should be interesting. Because I got, I should be able to get in there. Thank you. I'm gonna cut all these rails to length. This camera. Let's see. I'll be at the table saw. Back there somewhere. Thank you. I just worked out the basically the size of the tent idea on that. And that's about it for today, I think. Well, for right now at least, because I'm gonna go eat dinner. Dinner time. So, thank you for watching. It's a lot of fun. Yeah. I don't know. Hope you had fun. Hope you enjoyed the. It's been fun watching or fun building and all that stuff. So, I'm going to eat dinner. Thank you guys. Talk to you later.